Hey everybody, Cousin Jim, I'm headed out with my neighbor, Everglades 243. Bobby. We're gonna go out there. It's 3 o'clock in the afternoon. No, it's 4 o'clock in the afternoon. We're gonna head out and see if we can find any muttons today, any big mangroves. Who knows, we may even go off the edge of the reef. But we're headed out in Bobby's boat. We're looking to have a good time. You're gonna enjoy this show. Wait till we show you what we catch. All right, over here, we got Bobby dropping on the electric reel. We are only in 136 feet of water. The motor is off. If you wanted to go water skiing, you could ski behind this boat. That tide's got to be ripping at about 5 miles an hour. The wind's blowing the same direction, so we have good conditions, even though we have scary conditions. We're gonna have a blast. Bobby's got 5 pounds of weight on that, and look how that line is scoping out from the boat. It's not even dropping straight down. I got 8 ounces on my spinner rod and I'm way back there. So we'll see what happens. We're gonna have a blast fishing out here today.
Oh my God.
You got bit and missed.
Oh my God. You've gotta be kidding me. He took the bait. Let me finish rigging this.
Yeah, yeah. That's good. He took the bait. That means he's there. Here we got Bobby. He just butterflied the ballyhoo, took the head off, took some of the backbone out. It's gonna flutter down there like it's alive. We've got a bucktail jig up over our heads here, 4 ounces, so it's pretty near the surface swimming back there. There goes Bobby's big throw. No tangles. Just get it all out of the boat and we're in good shape. There it goes. He's dropping a, I thought he had a 5 pound weight, but it looks like he's got a 4 pound weight. We're headed down to the bottom and he's gonna pay way more attention to this rod this time.
Oh yeah.
Because he's excited now. You can see what happens to a fisherman. The first bite, he starts sweating. He starts telling lies. It's just the real fisherman's treat.
Oh yeah.
All right, fish on. Fish on, look at that. Coming up on the electric reel. Bobby's a good advertisement for Baitmasters right now. Check out that rod there. We got some bend. He's got a nice fish on there. That's a pretty heavy duty rod. We got a 4 pound weight on the bottom of it. Of course we were getting ready to rig another one when we got hit. That's what always happens. Here it comes. Should be floating any second. There he is. Big mutton. There we go. Nice mutton to start the day.
Everglades 243.
Nice job, man.
Thank you, sir. Watch your feet.
Yep, yep.
Watch your feet. Skill, brother.
He's close.
Skill.
Oh, yeah, he's got to be 18 now, but he's 20. He's going on ice up in the front where the chum is. Okay, so check this out. Butterflied ballyhoo. Gonna throw it out. Okay, here we go. 1.5 pounds headed to the bottom. Oh, let's turn that clicker off so it's not irritating. There she goes.
It looks like that the boat is moving, but we are actually anchored in place. That is just the current going by.
I got my finger on the side of the spool so it's not going down too fast. So we don't unspool at the bottom with this braid. Bobby's ready for another bite over there already. Shooting straight back like we're trolling. I think we're gonna have to go 4 or 5 pounds. There's fish number two. I couldn't get the camera to come on while he was coming in. He's gonna be close. This is how the mutton man says you get him off. Put a wooden spoon down in his mouth, give him a couple of twists, and they just come off. Fish is unharmed. We're gonna put a tape measure on him because he is really close. He's gotta be 18.
He's gonna be 16. 16.
18.
Wow, he is 18.
Can you believe that? 18 on the nose. Another keeper. Way to go, Bobby.
I think one might be on, just started cranking a little bit.
I
Probably got my bait. I give it a minute. I'm getting hit. You know, there's no doubt I was getting hit. I'm not used to having that big weight between the fish and me.
Unfortunately, this style of fishing with this current, you don't have a choice.
Yeah. It's the only way down there.
It's the only way down. And I'm still at 5 pounds, and I still got like probably a 20 degree scope. Look at you with 3 pounds. That thing's screaming out there.
I got hit so many times, I bet I don't have bait. So I had a bite. You can see he ate the butterfly off here, and he took me straight into this coral. I got a butterfly, another bait up. Here we go, going to the bottom again. Here we're headed down to the bottom. I got 4 pounds of weight. That might be bottom right there. I can barely pull the drag out. We should be there. Let's see what happens. Bobby's got a big one on. Look at that bite. It's a shark?
Yeah.
It looked like a big bite, buddy.
Oh, it was. It took so much line. We're gonna take a look at it right now.
All right, Bobby thinks he had a shark bite. I don't know.
That should wiggle now.
That should wiggle. All right. You got a hook left?
I don't think I've any.
Got everything? Bobby thought it was a shark bite. Looking like a shark bite.
To the critter.
Fish on. Bobby got bit again.
We're gaining.
I don't know what I'm doing. I have not gotten a bite. I'm gonna have Bobby butterfly it, put my bait down on the bottom. Want me to turn the motor to the left so it pushes the back end of the boat away from me? Here he comes, hand line on the last 40 feet or so. It's looking like a nice one. Should come up floating in a second. Ooh, oh, look at this grouper.
Big black.
Where's your gaff, buddy, up front? Don't worry about it. Look at the size of this big black grouper. Holy mackerel. This is exactly what we wanted. Come out mutton snapper fishing and accidentally catch a gigantic black grouper. Look at the size of this guy. You sure you don't want the gaff to pick him up? Look at the size of this fish. Bobby, you did wonderful. You just gonna pick him up in the gill?
Oh my God, he got bit by a shark.
He got bit by a shark.
That's why we lost him. Wow, yeah, get the gaff.
Okay.
Damn, what a shame. Took all the meat. Oh man, what a shame.
He didn't get all the meat. There's a pile of meat left on that guy.
What a shame, buddy.
He was a big one. Look how big that shark was. Took that bite right out of him. Good job, man. Bobby. Way to go, man. Woo! Everglades 243 on the fish.
God, bro, this was a freaking huge fish, man.
That was a monster. That was a monster. Shark got a lot of meat, but there's still 4 or 5 mils on him. Ooh, good job, Bobby. Great job. But look what that shark did to that guy. That's always a fear when you're catching these big fish, getting shark. Look at the size of this black grouper. He is huge. What measurement you got up there?
39, 40 inches.
A 40 inch black grouper, with a bite out of him, with a goober out of him. Man, he's big. So Bobby, you're gonna make a skull mount out of this guy?
Yeah.
Yeah, Bobby doesn't like me filming because we don't catch fish when we're filming. But there we go. A personal best. We don't hardly ever say that. Personal best for Everglades 243. We love this stuff. Having a blast out here. You know what though? I might reel in and have him rig me up. I've gotten a couple of bites. I've not gotten hooked up. He's getting hooked up every time. He definitely knows how to do it.
Nice job. I wonder if it was a shark all the way or if we had a fish on.
I had a fish on for sure. Because at first I was getting him. And then I wasn't getting him. And I'm gonna come up. Here we are to the floral.
Yep. Fish was on and he ripped the fish out of the hook. Now
my sweet ripped the hook right off the end here. Wow. Look at that. My knot held, or actually Bobby tied that one. Bobby's knot held, but just yanked the fish out. All right, so I just had something pretty big on, probably a mutton. Because I was gaining on him at first, and then he got sharked. Here we got some owner 6-0s. That's what I'm gonna tie on. We're gonna tie a loop knot like Bobby told me to for these muttons. I've done this fishing a little bit, but not as much as like catching dolphin. That's why I've got lots of dolphin videos. But I'm having fun out here with Everglades 243. But what we're doing on this is we're tying a loop in the line. See that loop? Then we're gonna put the hook on. So there's the knot. See, that's the loop. We're gonna wet it. We're gonna tie it tight. And then we gotta pull it on something. And that's what it looks like. I'm gonna cut the tag end off, leave about a quarter of an inch, and we're gonna go catch a big fish. Okay, we're out here at the witching hour. We got about 30 minutes of daylight left according to the sun. It is time for the fish to start biting. I just had a bite. Bobby's had a bite. Bobby's caught 3 fish today. I've caught none, but I've lost my bait almost every time, so I'm getting close. That was definitely a fish bite. I may have lost my bait.
Yeah, me too.
Take another black to get a tuna. I feel like I got a bait. Got half a bait. So there it is, half a bait. I'm excited to be out here fishing. I got hooked up, then I got sharked, but it's okay. We're just out here enjoying the manly fellowship that's out here on the water. This is the fellowship of the watermen. We're out here today, having a blast. I wonder if he ate my butterfly off and gave up. If I come up this time and all I've got is the plug and no butterfly, then I'm just gonna take a strip. Okay, it feels like I got half a bait again. So I bet he ate the butterfly off of this. And if that's the case, I'm just gonna put down a strip of ballyhoo, one side. So it will all be butterfly. Check that out, probably a small fish. Ate the butterfly. So when you're out here fishing, you're always trying to learn. So I've been losing just the butterfly portion of my bait. So all I am going to present to them is a butterfly portion of bait. So that's what's going down, just the butterfly. Let's see what happens. I had one bite and he left. Maybe he ripped my butterfly piece off. Just got a bite on the bait. Bobby said a mutton wouldn't like. So it's probably a shark. Actually, he said if he was a mutton, he wouldn't like it. But he's not a mutton. He just thinks like one. That's why we catch so many. I'm getting bites. I got grunts coming and eating the tail end of my bait.
I'm so tense with anticipation. I'm getting cramps in my back. Here, let's take the focus off of me. Let's go look at Bobby. What's he doing over here? You getting any bites there, Bob?
None yet. Seems to have turned off.
They moved to the other side of the boat. So let's just focus on what Cousin Jim is doing right over here. I probably lost my bait again the way things are going, because now I'm not getting hit. I got hit 4, 5, 6, 7 times, and now nothing. So we're gonna bring it up, see what we got. There's what came back up, people. I am not getting hooked up. I am getting bit. I'm losing my bait, but I'm not getting hooked up. Look how precisely Bobby is cutting that. And where do you want me to hook it? Right there at the fat end? He's shaping that so it's gonna swim like there's no tomorrow. And there is no tomorrow, unless we decide to go out. All right, that's where the hook goes. It'll be a great bait. Hey, I just got a bite. It's on Bobby's secret sauce. The flap that he skinned and cut into shape. Come on. Just as beautiful out here. 10 mile an hour wind blowing directly with the current. We couldn't ask for any better conditions. Anchor line is not in the way of fishing today. There's a bite. Did you see that, people? Well, Bobby, you slayed them today, man. 39 inch black grouper, couple keeper muttons. I had lots of bites. Great trip. Thanks, man. Thanks for taking me.
Heck yeah.